Hello, 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 everybody. Good to see ya. Things should be a little different looking around here. What is up? How's it going? How's everyone doing tonight? How's your week been? Let me get this chat set up. I'm just gonna tell you right now. You should be seeing me in all of my glory. Every blemish. I had to go and pretty myself up. I had to actually go get ready. This was ridiculous. I mean, this thing, I mean, you could see every imperfection, okay? So, sorry. Yep, JG even spots a new glasses, new everything. I'm ready. HD, baby. Oh, goodness. Daniel Gerber can't handle the high def. I don't know, man. I don't know if I can handle it. I'm seeing things on me. I'm like, man, you ain't looking too hot, man. You're looking kind of rough. Man, okay. A lot of you fools coming in here. Gary Franchi with the pre-game squad. Steve Dameron and the Linux Cat. Before him, though, shoot, we had Sherry G was in here at like 2 o'clock with me. So, ultimate pre-gamer. We had, shoot, it all disappeared. People pre-gaming for hours. You guys are insane. I'm going to kind of move this chat a little bit. I need to move it to where I can, you know, look. I mean, I'm looking. It looks like I'm looking that way. I'm not. It looks weird. Bear with me. This is all a learning curve, guys. Barn Door, Kevin Campbell, Mark Bond. So Mark Bond is actually legend. He's provided one of the flights we're doing tonight. So, and not, you hear me say one of? We're doing two. We're doing two flights. The Linux Cat, friggin' Donnie, sent me the other one. And with the week that I have had, we need to do two flights. That's all I'm going to say. I've pre-gamed for my own show. I've already pre-gamed. We're getting slammered. Let's just say that. Rough week calls for a fun Friday. That's my philosophy. Just created it. DC, Young Pai Chang, what is up? Uncle Buck, good to see you, buddy. Sugar Kitty. Speaking of Sugar Kitty, actually, this isn't speaking of you, Sugar Kitty. This just reminded me. Now that I have this new cam, I've been actually working on a Biggin cam. I had it all ready to go for tonight, but whenever I pull that camera out, when I open it on the stream, my computer dies. So, gotta work out some bugs. So maybe next time we'll have Biggin cam. Mike Meyer, what is up? Ben Demon Hunter. Kevin Campbell. Who else we got? These are the pre-gamers. Gary Franchi, already said you, but you're just pre-gaming. Lone Wanderer 360, what is up? Killco, what's up, buddy? Who else we got? Casey Jones, what is up, brother? Amy, the legend, Boom, welcome aboard. Dramhound, why do I have so many legends in my chat? I mean, seriously. Old Man Joe, what's up? Alright, we're getting to the bottom. I like this. This chat wheel I have up now is way better. Will Henderson. What's up? E.T. Phone Home is in here. What's up, E.T.? Chris Buzalencia. Cheers from Biloxi. Crafty God 77. Good evening. Pelsey Dime. What's up, legend? Cool Running. Hey, everyone. Mike Friggin Franklin. Who else we got? I think we're caught up. Kind of. Nope, there's Bubble Bath Bourbon. Hey, speaking of bubble baths, today is National Bubble Bath Day. In case you didn't know, might want to go take one. Go watch Bubble Bath Bourbon's videos. Tim Evans, what's up, legend? Good to see you, man. Bourbon Bites, Clifton, what is up, brother? All right, there we go. Now we're talking. I'm back down. Darrell, he was in here way, way earlier pre-gaming. Jerry Black, Mike Cook. He was already beautiful in low res. Oh, goodness. Oh, shoot. It just jumped all the way down to the bottom. If I miss you, I'm so sorry. just tag me and say you missed me. Scott Post, lurker. Scott Post, who the heck are you? Just kidding. I don't know. I don't know if I've recognized your avatar, you in the mask, man. What's up with that? Will Henderson coming in. Okay, so another thing, I just decided to go ahead and leave the firework thing up because I liked it. So, Will Henderson, thank you, brother. Nick Combs, new camera. Yeah, dude, this thing, you know, the autofocus on this, I can't really move a lot, so I'm having to be really slow. If I turn my head, like, to look back there and I come back, it kind of wigs out. It fixes itself, but it gets annoying. I've been messing with it all week. Andrew Buchanan, what's up, brother? Doug H! What's up, Doug? Where's your posse? Lord Jules. What is up? Shout out for the follow. Or, is that what that means? Mass Whiskey Cigar, what's going on? What's up, Mass Whiskeys and Cigars? Going good to see you. Phil Flameon, where's all these people coming from? Bev the Legend Porter, holy crap. I was about to say JG, but then I was trying to read JJ. What's up, JJ? Who else we got? Okay, one lime at a time. Cheers, surviving the first week of 2021. Friday at Fred's with Doug. There's Doug's entourage. Okay, so we just need. So I'm gonna go ahead and dedicate tonight to. So this is the first week. See how I look down and I look up and it kind of wigged out a little bit. Whatever, man. Whatever. Roy R does thing. Taking over Whiskey Tube. That's my plan. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead. Casey Jones, he's just super chatting with no message. Casey Jones, what's up? Thank you for supporting the channel. I'm just gonna go ahead and, you know, started out 2021 on a good. The Canon, Andrew Buchanan, the Canon new camera has you looking extra sexy. Thank you. You're such a scholar. All right. So, okay, we just got to get this thing out the table. Why we are doing two friggin' flights tonight, okay? There's a whole reason for it. Came into 2021. We're saying, yeah, this is a new year, new me. We got goals, baby. And what do? I hit a freaking deer and dang near total my car. Okay? So that's where we're at. 2021 looking a whole lot like 2020, let me tell you. And I need to look at you guys and not me. 2021 is looking a whole lot like 2020. But for real, terrible week. We're up to $6,000 in damage on the car. Okay? So the deer dang near won. But for real, I'm glad that it wasn't worse than it is. I've progressively felt worse every day since I hit this freaking deer. As soon as it happened, felt fine. Next day, felt fine. The day after, I started feeling a little stiff. And today, like, my chest has been killing me. My neck, I can barely move my neck. And I don't know why it's been so delayed, but I'm feeling freaking terrible now. And luckily, there was another guy driving. This is what happened. Dude's coming this way. I'm going this way. Deer comes out. Dude swerves. And as to me not to die, I swerve to not hit him. And the deer, you know, poof. In my car, poof. And then my wallet, poof. It was just bad. Yeah, if you're on my Patreon, you saw it. Good times. So, rough week. I'm ready to drink. And yeah, Casey Jones, seriously though, glad you're okay. Cars are replaceable. Exactly. I'm glad, you know, if the car hit me, probably wouldn't be here talking to you guys right now. So I'm glad I'm just having to borrow a car, and my car's in the shop, you know. So, and I'm just having to deal with some minor stuff to, you know, my neck and my back. How close am I to monetization? And then we're going to get into the first flight, which was sent by Mark Bond. And then after we wrap that up, we're going to do one from the Linux guy, because we need to celebrate me being alive. And the deer. We need to celebrate the deer. It was an expensive deer. And he gave his life. She gave her life to, I don't know. I don't know what she was doing. She gave her life. It's brave. Did you get to keep the deer? No, I kept driving. I was in total shock. Honestly, I've never had an accident, so that was the first time anything like that's ever happened. So, shoot. Monetization. I'm just lacking the hours. I need, last I checked, another 30, like 28 thousand minutes. So that's it. Donnie, the deer is just trying to see your hands and face. Yeah, the thing literally flew over my windshield right in front of my face. Like, I saw the whole shebang. I'm surprised. Another thing too, I'm glad that thing didn't fly through my windshield. I mean, it skimmed, it hit my windshield. Yes, waking up every morning is an awesome gift. Absolutely, and that's what we're doing. And day celebrating this. Just a few channel updates while we get into this. Let me get the sheet ready. Patreon rewards. The first round of them are out. They are shipped. They are delivered, or not delivered. I don't know if they're delivered. Someone's maybe delivered already. But they've been shipped. So I'm still waiting on some people's addresses. I'm waiting some people. I have another batch of glasses coming in. The more Kinsey glasses, so some people have to wait for those. And I'm talking just a couple. So that's where we're at. That is where we're at. DC dropping the links. Ben friggin' A. What is up, brother? You're just getting to the party. About time. All right, let me make sure I didn't miss anything. Yeah, living in Arkansas has its perks and downfalls. My wife had that happen last year. Yeah, I mean, come on. $6,000 just hitting a deer? Come on. All right, so this first flight, let's go ahead and get into it. So this is coming from Mark Bond. He's in the chat. He's doing the flight with me. So here's the rules. You have 4 samples. Try to pick out the wild turkey product, the $23 bourbon, the rye, and the 13-year MGP. I have to identify them. That's what we're doing for this first flight. I'm going to keep that there, 4 samples. Each. I mean, hopefully I can narrow it down from those hints, but either way, it'll be fun. Steve, hey! What is up? How's it going, Steve? You're the captain. Here we go. Ethan and Katie Turk. Glad you're okay. Get some venison steaks for revenge. Yeah, so I went back. I drove back down the road to see if I could see the deer and see what kind of damage I did to it. I guess the city moved it. I think the city moved it. It probably exploded. It looked like it exploded, so here we go. So we're getting into one. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go through the run pass because, like, some of them, like the $23 bourbon, there won't be any telltale signs. Like the rye and the MGP and the turkey, maybe I can find some notes for, like, this is a turkey product. What? Where do I look? Do I look? Does it distract you guys if I look up here? If I look at the camera. I want to look up there. See, this one's kind of, I don't know. It's kind of nutty. This one has some nuttiness going on to it. So I'm gonna hold my guesses. Look at the cam, says E.T. I'm looking at you, E.T. But then if I want to look at the chat, I gotta look this way. And that's what I might just read all the chat. Stanley Wagner Jr., you missed me. Oh my god. I'm so sorry, Stanley. Maybe I'm not that special anymore. No. Your package is coming. Package is coming. What if the 23 is Wild Turkey 101, says Tommy D. Doug H., I had a deer going deer hunting. Like, actually hit it in the car. Well, there you go. You just throw it in the back, go home. You save yourself a trip. I don't know. It could be. That's a good one. I don't know if he's trying to trick me, though. What's up, Josh Randall? Good to see you. Man, I don't know. This one's nutty. So maybe that is like a wild turkey. I don't know, though. I'm going to have to go through them and see if anything else screams it. But that one so far has a little nuttiness to it. Hank Butt's a little late, better than never. That's dang right. Better get something in the glass. Could a 23 Wild Turkey Rye 101? They're all the same. They're just four pours. Well, no, the MGP. Whoa. Huh. This one, okay. Just going off of price-wise alone, just based off the nose, I'm going to go ahead and eliminate that B is the $23. This one's not the $23 one. Just coming off of A and coming to this one, I hope that this one, I would hope that this one's more than $23. This one is deep and dark and seeing what the color, how this camera picks up colors. It's just a little oaky and charry and... Okay, so what are we looking at? 13-year MGP. I'm going to go ahead and... Just off this nose, unless this is a really, like a good Russell, like a Russell's or something from Wild Turkey. Ooh, even like a Wild Turkey. Shoot, I don't know if he would send me like a bottled and bond. No, that don't have that. No, this is older, though. This is... If it's not older... Shoot, he's trying to trick me. It's simple. So this seems so simple, I'll be honest. I looked at this and I was like, I'm going to be able to find out what that is. But then it's like, things are overlapping each other. Things that I'm guessing are overlapping with other options. John T., what is up, John? I think you have a... Yeah, you got something coming to you. Whiskey Wiggle. Sorry, just got here. Heard about the deer. Gonna grab a whiskey after I finish my beer. And you should start a band. Anyone else get a Pursuit United? Not me, Ethan. Yeah. Number two. So these are numbered. So two, deep and dark, and older than one. We're going to say that. I'm not a maker's guy, but you talked me into the 101. Didn't care for the first pour, but I revisited it the other day and really liked it. Short finish, though, but good. Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, 101 isn't going to blow your mind. I think if all you've really been into is just the regular Wild Turkey, and it's Wild Turkey, Maker's Mark. Yeah, it's a step above. It's a little better. I still prefer like Maker's 46 private selects and, you know, the stay finishing stuff they do. I enjoy it more than the 101. I like the 101 though, and I'm really glad they brought it so everyone can try it other than just the distillery stuff. Edward Fulmer, what's up? Cheers. So glad it's Friday. I'm done gargling this week's ball. Yeah, me too, man. JCB, cheers, everyone just got here. Happy Friday. Welcome aboard. I got a package today that said, from Sexy, MF-er from YouTube. You would know who that could be. No, it's probably John T. or Kevin Campbell or someone. Casey Jones, I don't know. Tito Dirk, lurking mode. He's going back to lurker mode. On to three. I almost want to go ahead and guess rye, but it's like, it's so subtle that it could be, I don't know. The other two, I don't think, I didn't have any hints of rye. I only say that because it's like, it really, it's opening up my nose. Like, smelling some some green gum. But it's not too rye-y. No. That's my initial thought, just coming off of those two. Let's go into four, and that's the nose, because I'm done smelling, man. I want to drink them. Ooh. Let me keep this here so the thing doesn't lose focus. Now we have a problem now. Did you try and trick me? Yeah, DC, thanks for dropping the good old the Linksky Links. Yeah, man, four is like, I almost smelling four, I want to say this is Wild Turkey. But then A was nutty. I think you tried to trick me. You trying to trick me? He sent me two. I bet you sent. Shoot, I don't know. He probably sent me the $23 bourbon, probably Wild Turkey 101, which is probably A. And then this is another turkey product. This smells so familiar to me. Whatever this is, I love it. This is what I'm talking about. This dude. Fire DC. DC coming back. Oh, goodness. I mean, this, it has that just, I don't know how to describe it other than that turkey dusty deliciousness. Oh, my gosh. Trev, just put you on my HDTV and wow, that camera is clear as day. I can see every booger in each nostril. Joe, if you guys see a blemish, just tell me. Old Tub is 23. Thinking I could. Let me go back to A. This is what we're going to do. I'm done nosing. Okay? A deer destroyed my freaking car. I need to drink these. So, let's get into them. Cheers to being alive. Cheers to new cameras. And this camera has come from Patreon. Patreon supported me. I'm upgrading, baby. All this stuff's going straight back into this to better. And with this camera, you know, who knows what comes with having a camera. So Mark Bond, cheers. Thank you for this flight. And thank you for drinking along with me. Heck yes. Here we go. I don't know. It's not Old Tub. Because I do not like Old Tub this much. This is really good. It's not over the top, though. It's like, I'll have to go through them. But right now, it's like I want to guess that it's the $23 one. But it doesn't really taste like $23. Like, this could be, I would pay more for this. That's what I'm saying. So, I don't know. Like, Old Tub, when I drink Old Tub, I definitely know that, yeah, this is friggin' Old Tub. I would pay $20 for it. I'm just not a big Old Tub fan. I think it's too citrusy. This does not have that. This is pretty mouth-coating. I think whatever this is... Well, shoot. Old Tub's unfiltered. I don't know. It's not, I don't think it's Old Tub. I don't think it's citrus enough to be Old Tub. Your mouth movements are telling me you're now a pro taster. I'm trying. Ryan Rivet. Cheers, Trev, with Fridays at Fred's and Doug Age. it's so fun saying all of you guys. Welcome, all three of you. You're all listening. You're all hanging out. Jacob Enriquez, Old Tub, somebody sent you sewage. It's not Old Tub, man. Stanley, you on StreamYard tonight? No, I haven't been on StreamYard in a hot minute, brother. I stream, for everyone wondering, I use OBS, Stream Elements, and a combination of the two. I'm streamed through OBS. Through YouTube. If that helps you. Because, here's the thing, StreamYard, I want to look the best. I want the quality to look the best. StreamYard makes you pay to have 1080p. They make you pay $50 a month to have 1080. I ain't doing that. OBS is free. 1080. Here we go. I just can't click your comments up on the screen. That's the only thing. Which I really like that. Michelle Lynn, what is up, Michelle? The more I drink that, though, the more it does have kind of a beam. You guys keep saying Old Tub. It's not Old Tub, but it does have a beamy nuttiness. So maybe that's not Wild Turkey. I don't remember, you know, I was at first thinking that might have been like Wild Turkey 101. I think it is around that proof, but I don't think, I'm starting to think it's more beam now. Maybe you're putting that in my head. I know there are deer everywhere, but what part of the country are you in? I am in Arkansas. Arkansas, that is how you say it. For anyone calling it Arkansas, I'm coming for you. Mouth coating for sure. Yeah, okay, Mark Bond. Oh, there we go. We're on the right track. Saw something else I wanted to read. Where'd it go? Austin freaking Feltz, the legend himself. Austin, you have a package coming any day now, brother. I want to see who gets it first. Like, who gets their stuff first. You're coming in so clear. I can see you have lipstick on. My lips look weird. They're kind of dry. OBS. Wait, whoa. See this thing? Okay. I'm back. OBS works pretty good when it works. I mean, it's worked for me every time. Oh yeah, this is what I needed to do. I saw Michelle commented again. Before I start drinking, number two, I'm gonna go ahead and say, disclaimer. Anything that happens to you during my stream, I'm not responsible. So. Any kind of falling, slipping, tripping. I don't know. Nice hanging on Friday. We're bringing more people every week for you. Who? Who's we? And where are you bringing them from? I have fun, man. I have fun hanging out with you guys and the support you've given me. I'm just trying to be better. I'm trying to grow, but I'm trying to grow with you guys, for you guys. I want to put out some killer stuff. The disclaimer over, just be careful, watch your feet, Michelle, and we're going to have a good night. and just don't blame me. It's not my fault. If it happens, it will take care of you, but not my fault. B is the one I'm saying off the nose. Smells the oldest. I mean, this thing smells deep and rich and full of everything good. Being Santa lately? William Sexy Name Davilar. Welcome in. I knew Michelle's here. You're not far behind. What's up, Beth Higgins? Richie Z? I don't know if I've called you guys out yet. Thanks again, my mods. All the moderators in here, if you're a wrench of the wrench, you are, what's the word? your royalty around here. Oh. That, ooh. Mark. This is delicious. Wow. This has got to be the oldest one. And if it's not, if this isn't the oldest one, I'm going to have to go between this one and D, because this one is friggin'... This is it. This is delicious. But I'm trying to find the Wild Turkey product to help eliminate that 13-year MGP that I'm supposed to be finding. But right now, this one, this could be a Wild Turkey. This isn't screaming MGP at me, but it's really freaking good. It drinks like it's older, and that's why I say it. It tastes a little older, but I'm still thinking like Russell's Reserve picks, the Wild Turkey, like all the Masters keeps. Those are deep and rich and crazy, so I don't know. I'm gonna have to wait until I get to the D to decide. Matthew Carr, what's up, brother? Stanley, was the deer playing a banjo? I don't know. It didn't last that long. I saw him. I saw his face. He was sad, and then he was dead. And it saddens me, but the sadness quickly was overtaken by anger, because I saw my friggin' headlight fly off into the distance. I saw my hood crumble up before my eyes, and then I don't care anymore. Didn't care. Bambi really pissed me off. Friday at Fred's. Forgot to put name. Friday, you didn't have to send another one, but thank you. Thank you. Thank you for supporting me. All of you guys. I feel like I just want to come and hang out with all of you guys in y'all's cave or wherever the heck you do this. Get together. Amy Boehm, you legend, dropping the thing. The Streamlabs link's how you get the fireworks to blow up. If you don't want to send that, I think I have a PayPal link. That's good to see. Tommy Boy Remake 2021. What? Is that a thing? Patrick Fulmer, he's back. What are you saying that to? Because I'm thinking of the Harry Potter reference. He's back. Anyone get that? You know what part of the movie that is? Stanley, just trying to make you laugh. I'm not laughing. Did the deer become your dinner? Everyone just... Can we drop the deer story? Drive, first time I've been able to view the live for a bit. Josh Pence, where the heck have you been? Where have you been? Pour a glass. Yeah, C. Okay, so I'm holding off on B. I think B is absolutely friggin' delicious. Drinking older could possibly be Wild Turkey. I don't know. But that's, we need to compare it to D, because I thought C on the first roundabout was the rye, which it has to be. All the others don't really smell like this, but this doesn't smell like super crazy. I don't know. It doesn't smell like super crazy rye. New camera's legit. Thanks. I think so. If you're ever in NOLA, chat us up. You're in NOLA? I didn't know this. I feel like I should. I feel like I have. I do. I did know this because I sent Ryan a package. Hand delivered it. I just didn't know that city that he was in is near NOLA. I have a buddy and his whole family lives down there. I'll come to NOLA. Yeah, this has got to be rye. I mean, it's really opening me up. Don't say anything about that. That's the rye. Hands down, That's got to be. It's got to be. Comprehensive is $50. I hit a raccoon at 70, destroyed my Cadillac. All dash lights came on. So, I was going 55 when I hit this deer. And it sounded like a freaking grenade went off. Granted, guys, come on. This is the first accident I've ever been in. Aside from, like, running a tank into a tree. And I broke the taillight. Army story. Backed the tank into a tree. Crushed the taillight. That's not an accident. This hitting this deer is the first time I've ever just destroyed something. So, yeah, I think it's scary every time you're in an accident, I'm imagining. But the first time, I had no idea what to expect. I hit it, and I just kept driving. I was kind of like, what do I do now? Am I able to make it home? Like, my car is smoking in front of me. Didn't feel anything. Like, I didn't feel bad. So I didn't think it was that serious, but Aiden Craig, what's up? Let me catch back up. I got hit by a big rig pulling a triple, popping my van like a balloon. So I'd say you're not doing too bad. Yeah, like I said, friggin' this is nothing compared to what I imagine it could have been and what others have been in. So I'm glad that it was so light compared to. I'm glad it ended up being, you know, in a sense, nothing. I don't know, $6,000 though. I guess it really jacked something up in there. Like, $6,000? What? Jerry G's back. Okay, so we're on to D. I'm calling D, 4, whatever, the fourth one. I'm calling 3, that's the rye. It's gotta be. Gotta be the rye. This is gonna be difficult. That headlight assembly is probably $1,500 just for one part. Yeah, and another thing too, like, my car being as new as it is, it's probably everything's just more expensive. It screwed up the radiator, that's for sure. There was green fluid spewing into my garage. Tyler H, cheers. What is up, brother? Sounds like they need to put backup cameras in tanks. You know what? You know what our backup camera is? True story. True story, a backup camera is a dude gets out of the tank, runs to the front, and he says, where am I? He goes. So this dude told me to keep going. Hold on, see? See the focus? It's trying to focus back there now. The only problem. There we go. The only problem with that is he can't see the tail light on the other side. Isn't near the friggin' tree. So he said, yeah, you're good. You're good, just keep backing up. And the next thing I know, I hear a loud noise and I'm not moving anymore. So it's not my fault. Not my fault. And if I ever, another thing, guys, if I lose focus, just tell me and I'll kind of reach up and refocus. Steve, right. Shut up, Steve. You don't know me. Okay, I'll be honest. On the nose, this is screaming turkey. But on the palate, it wasn't. Let me go back. Man, I don't know. Was it an M1 Abrams? No. I forgot what the MOS for Abrams. That's a whole MOS. 19 kilo, I think. Something like that. But You have to go to school to learn how to drive that. Like, you have to, that's has to be your actual job. It was a M1126 Striker, or you can just Google Striker. So I guess it wasn't necessarily a tank. More, it's called an ICV, infantry carrier vehicle, but it's a freaking tank, essentially. On, it's like a tank on wheels. Let me go back through. So I'm just going to go ahead and just... I'm not even going to guess what rye 3 is. I have no freaking idea, but it's a rye. 3 is a rye. I'm going back and forth between B and D because they're both... They're the ones that are giving me trouble. Man, whatever B is so mouth coating and so deep and dark and everything good. That is really good. I don't know what that is. It's not screaming anything. That's why I don't want to guess that that's turkey. I'm going to have to say D is the wild turkey. I'm going to have to go back and guess which one it is. B, so that makes B, on my guess, I'm thinking A might be the $23 one. C, or B, by elimination, is 13-year MGP. 3 is the rye, hands down. And then 4, you know, I wanted to guess 4 is wild turkey off the nose. So I don't, 13-year MGP, I have no idea, but it's really good. It doesn't really taste like other MGP things I've had. That's the thing. That's why I didn't immediately say, oh, that's MGP. Hey, look at all you guys dropping Striker facts, man. You guys know what that is? I didn't know what that was. I got stationed at a Striker unit having no idea what those were. And then I show up and I'm like, oh, I joined the infantry. What are these vehicles? Like, oh, we're going to be using these? No idea. Yeah. Lone Wanderer, we have Striker Unit Fort Lewis. Yep. The 2nd Infantry Division's up there. And I think there's a Ranger Battalion there. Either the 1st or 2nd Ranger Battalion's up there in the 2nd Infantry Division. I've had several buddies, and I had a old... he wasn't a team leader of mine, but he was in my platoon. He deployed with him, and he was such a freaking awesome guy. I guess they just kind of move you, like, once you're in a Striker unit, I guess they kind of move you around to other Striker units, because that's the only places he went to. Man, Dan L, who is this flight from, and what is the theme game? Join late. Dan L, for one, welcome, because I know I've heard about your whole fiasco with the internet. 2, this is from Mark Bond. The theme is just, he sent 4 samples and I have to pick out the wild turkey, the $23 bourbon, the rye, and the 13-year MGP. That's what we're doing. I feel like I'm on it. Then again, like, I'm guessing this has to be the 13, and I called it from the very beginning. This smells just old. It's gotta be. That is so good, man. C is the rye, hands down. Let me double confirm. Back from lurking, Trev knows his MGP, Tim Evans, people like you, freaking hot buttery rolls, the dang MGP fiends. Trev knows his RPG, what's up DMC Kentucky, aka Prescription Bourbon, awesome channel, go check him out, we help everyone. This is what we do. This is the community, man. Let's see. I just saw something else. Strikers, yeah, they're the ARs of war, tons of versions. Yeah, we never, in ours, we just had the M1126. There's tons of them. Like, the number kind of tells what it is. So, like, I don't even know what the other numbers are. I just know, like, there's M11, yada, yada, yada. No idea. No freaking idea what any of the other ones were, because the entire unit, I don't think we had them. We had a couple of those ones with a huge cannon on it. That was for the Cav Scouts down the way or something. I don't know. We didn't have them. Remus is MGP. So let me try and help me figure this out. Let's guess it. While we still have time. We have about 15 minutes before we're going to go into another flight. Another flight. Rough week. Two flights. That's just what we do. Remus. So let me tell you like what I think the proof is. It's drinking. I don't know. It's over 100. I'm conflicted at how high it is, though. I don't know if it's 115 and below. Let me go to D, because D was the other one that I thought was kind of higher flight. So I need to compare it. Remus is 100. This isn't a Remus, then. Yeah, Austin Feltz. Two flights? Yeah. That's how we do it, Austin. I'm going to guess. Shoot. Well, no. No, 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 no. Holy frick. I got it. I don't got what B is. I think I might have pinpointed what D is, if my guesses are correct. That's got to be a Jim Beam. After I drink them, Jim Beam, what made me, I'm going to go ahead and call that is Jim Beam. Hands down, because there's this weird thing when I drink a Jim Beam thing, and then I drink other stuff, and then I go back to Jim Beam, and it's 23. I'm calling that the $23 bourbon. Their cheaper lineup, especially when I drink it, and then I go to other stuff, and then go back to that, it gives me this certain taste in my mouth. And I don't like it as much if I just have it. Let me try and explain this because I'm rambling. When I first have it, I really like it. When I have it after a bunch of other things, it gives me this weird taste, like a weird extra taste that wasn't there on the first time that I don't like. And now I'm getting that. Finally, I'm getting it, and I'm hands down, that's Jim Beam. It's like it turns into a musty peanut. So that peanut that I was getting that I really liked, after having all of these other ones, it turns into a musty peanut. That's what happens. I got it. Steve A. So I'm way back up here. Where is it? The M1128 is the fun one. The one with a 105mm tank. Never seen one. I was in a striker unit. We didn't have one. We had, our tanks had every other truck. So it would start with a 50 cal on the top. Truck 2 would have Mark 19, which is an automatic grenade launcher. Truck 3, 50 cal. Truck 4, Mark 19. And that's the whole platoon. So a platoon of guys is 4 trucks. And we would do everything together. All four trucks were doing everything together. We had maneuvers and, you know, it's like playbook. It's like the playbook for football, you know, truck one does this, truck blah, 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 blah. Basically the same thing. Pretty much. Army's like football. Musty Peanut, Old Tub, Jerry Black. Everyone's saying Old Tub. I don't think that's Old Tub, though. Old Tub, I get on it citrus. Like a citrusy, like an old granddad. I get a lot of citrus on it. I'm not getting that on this one. So I'm trying to think of another $23 Jim Beam. I don't know. I'm still calling it Jim Beam. I don't think it's Evan Williams. I think it's Beam. Well, shoot. Evan Williams Bottle and Bond. I'm sticking with it. Don't throw me off, Edward. What's up, Donald Rance, the Irish Whiskey Yoda? Okay, so B is the 13-year-old MGP. I'm guessing around, I don't know, 115 proof. It drinks decently hot, but not too hot. Can't wait till Sunday, Porter and fam coming to stay with us. What? How long are they going to be there? And when do I get to come? Ed Cummings, you were in here earlier. About time you got here, a little tardy to the party. Had to get my 4-year-old to sleep. And that's a perfect segue into a shout out. Let me get back in focus. Ed Cummings, absolute legend, sent me one of, if not the coolest coin ever. Look at how massive this thing. Let it focus. Focus. Hide my face. Man, this focus is too good. Just know this coin's awesome. Can't even show you the back of it, but man, this coin, it's a Sergeant Major Academy challenge coin. And this thing, I could throw it at you like a friggin' ninja star. And you'd be done. You're out. You're done. I mean, seriously, this thing is solid. Yeah, coaster. Someone said coaster. That's the freaking coolest coaster I've ever had. I don't know. I can't use that as a coaster, though. Like, that is frame-worthy. All my coins, I'm getting, like, a coin holder, and I'm displaying them. Because so many of you have sent me some awesome coins. 3. I'm calling it the Rye. It doesn't drink too hot. It might drink less than A. But it's pretty flavorful, so I don't... That one's hard. Rye is hard for me. Because I feel like the spiciness gives a false sense of proof. But that's rye. That is definitely rye. He didn't tell me to guess the proof, but if you want me to guess the proof, I'm going to guess around, like, 95. I don't know. And that leaves us to D, which I'm calling Wild Turkey. I got you, Donnie. Donnie, I see the phone's blowing. I see you, brother. I'm getting there. We're coming up next. Drinking some swordfish oil tonight. Paired with a Oliva Nadiro cigar. Ed, thank you. You're an absolute legend, man. Cannot thank you enough. And another, you know, here's another thing. Before we go into D, we're going to wrap it up, do Donnie's. So many of you checked on me after this whole deer fiasco. Man, you guys know how to make a dude feel good. So many people just messing me. Hey, man, you okay? Like, at the time, I was like, yeah, I don't even feel anything. I don't even feel sore. I'm good. But you still took the time to reach out to me, man. It really does mean a lot. And all of those who didn't, you hate me. Fine. I'm kidding. Dang. This is tough. I still think this is Wild Turkey. I'm struggling at which one it is. And I know that he didn't say this. He didn't tell me to, but I want to. At first, I almost, in the very beginning, I was saying maybe Russell's, like a Russell's Reserve. The single barrel. Because I do not remember. And that's the thing. That would mean that's about 110 proof. This kind of isn't drinking like 110 proof, so that's making me second guess the thing. So, but then again, I don't remember Wild Turkey 101 tasting like that. It's not drinking like 110 proof. It is full of flavor, so maybe I'm just getting a little slammered and I'm not comprehending proof. But I'm gonna have to stick with it. That's Wild Turkey. I'm guessing it's Russell's Reserve single barrel, the red label. Whoa! You didn't see anything. You didn't see anything. My lamp fell over. My light was making me look pretty. Galen Brubaker, are you freaking done with your test so we can play some Warzone? JG, come on, dude. I'm not wearing lipstick. Let's get into this fight. Ben A, just checking. How are you doing, man? Ben A, hey, I know you like me, dude. We talked on the phone the other night. Me and Ben, we stayed on the phone. Friggin', how late in the night? So, Ben, during that talk, we were up so late, my phone died in the middle of this talk we had. There was like four or five of us in there. Up all night, phone died. Then I was kind of drunk. I went to sleep. Whatever. Here we go. Shoot, I'm opening this up as if I have the answer key over here. Let's find out what this is. Mark, you ready? And then we're gonna get into another flight. We're just gonna go straight into it. Two flights. Why not? Roy R. Glad you're okay. We all need a healthy wrench. Roy, you are a legend, dude. I love you, man. You're like in my Instagram stuff. You found all my Instagram pages. By the way, I have a Bourbon Wrench Instagram at the Bourbon Wrench. Another thing is, and you know, you guys, everyone here probably knows who I am, but I did change my YouTube URL to youtube.com/TheBourbonWrench, and that'll get you here. Don't think you'll ever get here that way, but just know that's a thing. You on PSN? No, Edward, I'm on Xbox, but can't we play together? I play with Dan, and he's on PC. I don't know how PS4 works, or 5, or whatever. Cameron Lochner, what's up, Trev? Sorry I'm late. Okay. Friggin' Marine, you're late. What does that mean? How many push-ups? Go. Until I'm tired? Okay. Ernie Brubaker, the Brubaker Maker. You know when you see Caitlin, you see Ernie. All right, here we go, guys. We're finding out what these are. Just a recap, I'm guessing A is the $23 bourbon and it's Jim Beam. I don't know which one. I really don't know. It doesn't taste really like anything I'm that familiar with. I'm going to guess not Old Tub, just for the naysayers. Not 90 in chat. What? Hit the like button. 90 in chat. Holy crap. I did not know that. Lurkers, check in. Jen Artolino. Good to see you, Jen. I saw you earlier. Where's Cheech? I'm sure he's doing a gig or something. Jim Beam, $23, no idea. B, 13-year-old MGP, no freaking clue. Three is rye, no idea what it is. Four, Wild Turkey, going with Russell's Reserve Single Barrel. So I'm guessing maybe B might be the highest proof. It drinks like it around 115-ish, maybe. D has to be 110 if I'm guessing Russell's. The rye, man, that one, it really, really throws me off. I don't know, man. Around 100, 95, 100, I don't know. And A is probably around 100, too. Chris S. Lurkin, Chris Buzalincia Lurkin. Phone Doctor, I knew you were here. You have a package coming to you, too, brother. Just let me know when you get it. Daniel, what's up? Richie invited me over. Daniel, if you know Richie and you're here, then you, for one, you know the coolest dude ever. Two, you're in the right place. Michelle Lynn, sharing my love. Happy Friday. Thank you. Your money's going towards preparing so I can drive to work in an actual car. Let's get into it. Here we go. Oh, Mark Bond, I'm a friggin' legend. So one, I guess, was Jim Beam. It was the $23 bourbon. It is the Jim Beam Distiller's Cut. 100 proof, unfiltered. That explains it. I haven't had Distiller's Cut in over 2 years. But that makes sense because it's so mouth-coating. The unfiltered, hashtag unfilter all bourbons. Oh, all of them are on here. What am I doing? B, or two, Joseph Magnus Bourbon, 13-year-old MGP, single barrel store pick. 106 proof. And I guessed 115. Whatever, I'm off. But I did guess that that was 13-year-old MGP. Delicious. That is delicious. Tell me where I can get one of those. Three, I guess, was the rye. I guess 95 to 100. It's E.H. Taylor straight rye, bottled in bond, 100 proof. That one does not drink very rye-ish. It's like a, it's a, almost like a high rye bourbon, to be honest. Four. Oh, I hit the net. No, I didn't. Kind of. It is a Russell's Reserve single barrel store pick. 9 years. Warehouse A, floor four. Just go with your gut instinct every time. Total Wine has the Magnus bottles, but they're above 150. What? Ah, shoot. All right. Okay, so Donnie, I missed your thing, but I still see it, so don't worry, brother. We're the family left behind after the untimely death of the deer. Oh, way to make me sad. So what I like to do... And don't worry, Mark, I saved over... I have a half of all your samples left, but because we're getting slammered tonight, I just mixed all of those left. And oh no, I lagged. I'm lagging. Tell me if you hear me. I froze. I'm frozen. Do you see me? We hear you. Frozen, but we got audio. See you. Frozen. Video's frozen. Hold on, guys. Hold on. What the heck? What the heck? I'll fix this. I might disappear for a second, but you guys can hear me, so we're good. Hold on. Are we back? Is that it? I think that's how I fix it. We fixed it. DH Silv, that's a serious face. I'm confused. We're back. We're back. And with that, you know what we're freaking doing? Because now I'm pissed. Blame the deer. Blame 2020-21. Cheers, my friends. Down the hatch. Here we go. With that being said, round two. Oh, shoot. Super Chat the Cannon, you are the next world's top whiskey taster. I'm coming for you, Matt. God dang chugging time. You just showed up at the perfect time, Dustin. Perfect time. And then Amy, I missed it, for Trev's Auto Body and Repair and Biggin's Treats. Biggin is sound asleep. If the Biggin cam worked, I would show you him. He is adorable. Amy, if you saw Biggin, you would send another. He is adorable. Are you drinking Weller CYPB or what? I saw the pic. I did it because I won it. I will drink it. But what I have to do, so Donnie sent me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me start pouring these first. I'll give you some notes on the, as you can tell, it's already open. The CYPB is open. Dan L. was there. He witnessed it. Donnie, what the heck is this? Your samples go B, C, E, F, J. So I'm guessing B, I'm guessing B is A. I'm going to do B is A. Am I correct though? So B, I'm pouring B is my A. B is A. Just do an order. Okay. And then I'm going C. Curiosity Public. Everyone go check out. You guys know Curiosity Public. Mark Bond, dude. You're a legend. That was an awesome. I enjoy that. I enjoy the simplicity. Yet it was still super hard. When I say simplicity, I mean like one's wild turkey. One's rye. One's $23. Because it really messes with your head. Yeah. Dutch. Curiosity Public. Seriously, the dude, the whole channel is the reason why I even got into bourbon. You know, I can't tell you how many people I know were doing, watching the Bourbon Guild back in the day. So if everyone remembers Bourbon Guild, Curiosity Public, go watch them. Same thing. It's different, but it's different in a good way, okay? They've really upgraded friggin' everything. It's just a good time, man. E, F, J, B, C, D. No, B, C, E, F, J. Are you kidding me, Donnie? What the heck is this? I have to get one more glass because I only have four glasses. Jay, the outlier, is going into friggin' this big old glass. Yeah, drop that link for Curiosity Public, man. Hank Butts coming in. Great flight, Trev. Be back in 20. Hurry up. Jen and Cheech. Jen has been streaming your videos all week, 25 plus hours. That explains it, and whenever I hit the goal, I'm gonna show you guys the graph that's in my YouTube studio. Like this month is like way above the friggin' thing. You guys are going above and beyond, I'm telling you. So here we go. This is Donnie's. Let me read Donnie's messages. I just want you to tell me what you think it is. Bourbon, rye, finished, etc., and the proof. Love the countdown. Don't think I'm supposed to read that. Down with MGP? The rules. Is it bourbon, a rye, or burr rye? What is the proof? Lastly, pick your favorite. Enjoy. From Donnie. Here we go. So Mark Bond provided the first one. Donnie the Linux Cat provided the second one. We're getting slammered. You know, this is, you know, at first I was like, this is because my car is destroyed. Yada, yada, yada. Whatever. No, it's because we lost a good deer. She was a beautiful deer. Bambi. She probably had children. Very sad. Much more sad than my car having $6,000 worth of damage. Friggin' Bambi. DMC Kentucky for the car camera fund. So the camera fund is done, bro. That's going to the car fund. DMC Kentucky has a channel called Prescription Bourbon. Mod, drop the link to Prescription Bourbon. Check him out. He's one of us. D. Willett, what's up? Having me some C919. Welcome. Cherry, if I'm on my computer, one of your videos is on tabs. Exactly. You guys are getting me there. Here we go. And I'm guessing this is called Down with MGP. So all of these are MGP, Donnie. So this is going to get really confusing for you guys. So I'm just going to go ahead and say this is A, B, C, D, and E. And we're not using Donnie's lettering system. So number one, A. Okay. And you notice that I smelled and then went straight into drinking. I think we're at the point in our life. That's what we need to do. 105 in chat. Hit the like button. Welcome aboard. I love you. Drop any of your questions. If you want to know anything, I'll read it. The chat is open. Questions are open. I'll tell you stories. I'll tell you whatever you want to know while I drink this MGP goodness. I just have to guess what it is. Comes from MGP. Ooh, this one smells way different than A. That's what's crazy. MGP doing it right because they are way different. That might be a burr rye. He said burr rye. I've never had burr rye. Well, I have. I've had it in samples, but I've never owned burr rye, so I'm not familiar with it. Smelling B and then going into C makes me think that almost want to be burr. So 100 peeps watching 2 hours tonight is 200 hours towards the number. That simple. 100. No, that would be. Well, yeah, it would be 200 hours if they watch the whole time. It goes in watch minutes. They want 240,000 watch minutes. I'll give you a live update. Sherry G, car fun. Glad you are okay. Sherry G, your package is coming to you. I threw a little something in there for you, but you'll see, Sherry. You already have what I sent you, so it's not even that special. It ain't Friday without the bourbon wrench. Well, you know what, frickin' Doug? It ain't Friday. It ain't it ain't the bourbon wrench without Doug and his entourage. Period. But Sherry, what I'm saying is I sent you a sample of something that you had said that you had never had. But then I saw later, because you know how I'm in every chat, I saw that you were drinking. You said, I'm drinking this, and it's the sample of what I sent you. Just spoiler alert, ding, ding, ding. Julielle, how many more hours? That's what we're going to right now. We are at, so let me go to watch minutes. Let me do the last 365. So I'm at currently, before this video, so before this, 212,505 watch minutes. I need 240,000 watch minutes. And is it just live streaming minutes, Tommy Gilligan? No, it is not. It is, it's basically, it's watch minutes as in any video you have, the amount of time a viewer watches. So if you go, if you just pull up someone's video and you watch 3 minutes, their channel gets 3 watch minutes added to it. So it's just however many total watch minutes of any video that they get. So that's what it is. Must be feeling it. Flight number 2 is going to be pretty smooth. Question, if you drink glass cleaner, will it kill you or just make you see better? Cameron, I don't know about eating glass, drinking glass cleaner, man. Probably shouldn't do it. I know that you're into eating crayons, you're a Marine and all, but you probably shouldn't drink glass cleaner. You owe me 50 push-ups. B's got to be bourbon. And I say that because I'm a total bourbon schnob. I like rye. Don't get me wrong. I like rye. In fact, some ryes I love. But when you start tainting bourbon with rye, I notice it. I think A is a burr rye. I'm going to stick with it. Gut instinct. Gut instinct. A, burr rye. B, bourbon. Going on to C. We're moving through this one quick. I know what I'm doing. I'm warmed up now. I'm lubed up. After tonight's stream, I will have at least 10 to 15 of your streams running all week. And holy Daniel Carver, we're going to, next time you guys see me, we're going to be at 240,000. Let's see. Let's get Trev over the minimum. Everyone watch this video tonight. You will be sleeping. Simply. Drayman, did you post like the 5.5 hour stream I did? I was reading what Dutch said because I value anything Dutch says. If Dutch says it, I just do. Dutch, you do. What happened to Dan and Julie? Oh, I saw Tim Evans. The legend. Hey Tim, by the way, while we're smelling this, Tim, I have to pick up one of your samples because you won a sample during the last giveaway stream. You won a sample from somebody who lives 3 minutes up the road from me. So I'm not kidding. Like he lives miles from me. So I'm going to go just pick it up from him, and I'm going to send his and mine, because you won one from me, too, and I will send it to you. So that's the holdup. All right. C. Smells bourbony, very, very caramely. Very caramely. Down with MGP. Note the question mark. Key. Now, has what you called them and what... and Key. Now has what you called them and what Miss Linux Cat labeled. Dude, Donnie, you better not be messing with me, because I have a flight in front of me, and if you're trying to trick me, it's going to go over my head. Have you tried the Woodford Rare? No. Located one today. If it's like retail or a little above, and you don't want to buy it, Tim, hit me up. The new one? Hit me up. Hit me up, Tim. And I say slightly above. This deer just hit me, just destroyed my vehicle. That's why I'm saying. I don't have the money to spend on it. There we go, Tim. Okay, I'll take it. Huh. Shoot. That one doesn't taste like anything. It might be like younger bourbon, but it could also be... JG sent you a super chat not seeing it. Did you send it? JG, I got you. You did not send it via Stream Elements. You sent it via PayPal, so I have to read it. That's how we got to do it. Donnie, we're on C. On your end, it's E, you freaking goob. JG super chat reads, JG, it's not Friday without you saying 877 MASH now. Insurance should pay all but your comprehensive deductible. Trev. Bev, yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm sure, you know, this is all going to be taken care of. It's going to be fine. But still, I just kind of want to tone down the bourbon spending this month and get this car situation, you know, figured out. I mean, I'm so friggin'... I take care of everything. Like, these glasses that I own, these will last me years and years and years because I take such good care of them. I'm OCD about my property, like things that I've spent my money on. Like, I hate when someone comes and grabs a bottle of mine. I'm eyeing them like a hawk. You better not drop that friggin' bottle. What are you gonna do with that bottle? You know how many people have asked me in my life, "Hey, can I see your glasses?" No. You can't see my friggin'... Look at them. You can't wear them. These things cost money. You can't wear them. So, to see my car freaking smoke coming out of it and green fluid spraying the ground of my garage, I was in shambles. I was distraught. Distraught. Hit a deer about 5 weeks back. I feel your pain. Tyler, how much damage did it do to your car? It's 2021. Do you need a car? DH Silv, no, I have a vehicle. I'm driving to work. Fine. I'm just pissed. James Taylor. Hey, Donnie, Trev, everyone cheers. James Taylor, what's up, brother? Z-Man. You got a package coming to you, brother. Just saying. Oddly enough, Trev has a shirt on that he's wearing, and it cost money. And if you... Okay, it's funny you say that, Dustin. If I This is the kind of person I am. It's weird. It is really weird, and I'll admit it. If I rip a shirt, I'm pissed. I am absolutely mad. Like, if I walk by something and it snags and bam, I got a little hole, absolutely destroyed. I am so sad. I don't know. It's weird. I love taking care of my possessions. Like, I just baby everything. It's weird. Diana, sorry about that, Trevor. We had 75 sample bottles from advent calendars and tried to get letters as close together. Hey, I'm giving you a hard time. The Linux cats, I will never... You could have sent me freaking cryptic codes that I had to decipher and I would have been fine. I love you guys. So let me go on to D. Three, I'm telling you, so... C or three, I don't know. It might be like a younger bourbon. They're wanting me to guess what it is. Like if it's bourbon rye or if it's finished. I don't know. It could be, I don't know. A younger bourbon is what I'm guessing. Robotic. That's not even it. And in a fault loss, you are good. Yeah. And I'm sure it's going to be fine. It stresses me out. I've never been in an accent, not a fender bender, not a freaking anything. So this is like my first time going through this, so I'm kind of stressed out. Matt Hager, who the heck are you, Matt? Matt, post in the comments right now. Where'd you come from? You're a lurker. Why would Trev Wilson make fun of us for eating crayons? He's another Marine coming out of the woodworks. He was probably chewing down on the red crayon and he couldn't comment before this. Bev, I totaled our car in fall of 2015. Don't drive anymore. She just doesn't drive. Dustin Hendricks, so there he is. Literally joined as you explained the holdup. I broke my last bottle meant for the giveaway, and my new ones took forever to come. It's sealed and ready. Hey, so I'll be honest. Dustin messaged me like 2 days ago. This is totally to Tim Evans because Tim Evans is a legend. Tim, your sample from Dustin has been ready for a couple days. I've been so busy at work that I could not get it from him. I'll meet up with Dustin. Dustin lives right down the road from me. So I will go get your sample from him tomorrow, and I will package it up. It'll probably go out to you Monday. But yes, I'll go get it from Dustin. That means I get to meet Dustin. I'm meeting Dustin. I'm meeting one of you guys in the chat. Emily Chambers, what the heck is up? So Tyler, I asked you earlier, luckily just front end damage, new bumper and grill, insurance covered everything. Okay. Lucky. I'm sure we'll see how it turns out for me. You might see me next week and I'm like, guys, this is it. We done. So I'm on to D. And the D is always good. I haven't been in an accident in a long time, but I have a feeling I've caused several. Dan? Probably. Wouldn't doubt it. I'm drinking really nice. I'm proud of Trev nailing this on the first flight. And then Mark Bond says, nailed it. He is better than ever. Richie and Mark, I'm on it. I'm recovered. The COVID helped me, man. I came back after COVID freaking ready. Next week, you'll be monetized. Yes. And you know, here's the thing. Here's the catch with the monetization thing. Yeah, I'll be able, once I start producing videos, I'll be able to monetize them. As far as like super chats go, I'll be full transparent with you guys. I don't know how you guys feel about the whole stream elements link that I have my mods drop. But there's something, and it's not just me. Don't take this the wrong way. I am very salty that YouTube takes 30% of super chats. I think that's ridiculous. I don't think, and here's the thing. When I want to go super chat another channel, if I give them $10, I'm intending all 10 of my dollars to go to them. If ADHD Whiskey, who's coming up, if I give him $10, I want him to get $10. I don't want him to get $7 when I sent him $10. That makes me mad as the super chatter. For what? Why are they taking $3 of my money? It pisses me off. And it pisses me off as a giver more than a receiver, because receiving anything from you guys, that's amazing. You guys are supporting me. But as a giver, knowing that my freaking $3, they're taking three of my dollars from the $10. Why? Why are you doing that? Ethan Dirk, because they can. Exactly. But it makes me mad. Like, support the streamers. Get your ad revenue and call it good. Let the streamers get the donations that they deserve. If I give them $10, let them get $10. At least drop it from 30. Drop it down to 10%. Take a dollar from it. Not 30. Yeah, and Josh Randall, but people donate 5 times as often only because it's easier. And I get that. It's a double-edged sword. I don't know. Yeah, but you couldn't super chat him if YouTube didn't exist and they couldn't exist without the income. But, you know, I don't know. I feel like the whole 30% is a bit too much. But here's the thing, Julie. We all know this. YouTube is making millions, if not billions, of money off of these people. Not from just streamers, but just as the company as a whole. They can afford to drop their rate from 30 down. Guaranteed. They're making a lot of freaking money. So that's the thing. And, you know, that's the thing, Donnie, take the money and call it a day. And that's the thing, I don't want to sound ungrateful. It's just, I, as a consumer myself towards other channels, I think it's ridiculous. I would much rather PayPal that channel my money, is what I'm saying. I would rather just give them, hey, here's $10. Versus, hey, hey YouTube, I want my chat highlighted for $3. No, come on. That's the thing. That's my thing. Is I'm paying YouTube $3 to highlight my chat in green, which they probably see my chat anyway. I don't know. Meanwhile, are you really friends and family when you send a channel a PayPal? Yes, you are my friend. DH Silv, you are my family. For as many late night chats as we've had, Dustin, you're my family. Let's get on to D. I'm off my soapbox. I'm just saying. Just saying. Man, this is difficult. Because I almost want to say that one's finished. But I'm only guessing that because he messaged me. Is it bourbon, burry, finished, and then etc.? What is etc.? But this one's almost like wine-like. Matt, I respect your knowledge of making fun of Marines. Weirdos. Love your channel. You're a handsome man. No homo. How do we go about sending you a bottle, Matt? For one, dude, you don't have to do that. I have plenty of bottles. If you feel so inclined and that my heating has no effect on you, you can email me at bourbonwrench@gmail.com. I will respond to you instantly. But otherwise, dude, you don't have to do that. If you're a Marine, dude, I make fun of you, but you're my brother, and you don't have to do that. Don't have to do it. I will send you, though, a 64-count pack of crayons. The big one with the pencil sharpener on the back. I don't know. It could be bourbon. It could be friggin' finished. This is hard. MGP, all of them being MGP, that's hard, man. It's very hard. There's like a fruitiness on this, on D, and that's why I'm saying finished. My money is on the D. Who set you up? Donnie set me up. It's like fruity. So anytime I get that amount of fruity, and then I get a hint of, there's a finished one, that's what I'm guessing. Bourbon Baller? Where the heck did you come from? Who are you? Welcome aboard. Outside of BTAC, what are your dream bottles? What I'm after now? So I have an Old Fitz 9-year. I would really like one of the older Old Fitz. Like an Old Fitz 9 or a 15. Or like the Distillery Only 16. That's kind of what I'm after. Over the BTAC. Like I would love a William LaRue Weller or George D. Stack. I mean, who wouldn't? Duh. But as out from that, Old Fitz 15 or the 16, if I see it, I'm doing it, period. Spend your money on crayon or on more crayons, no store brand. Oh, Matt. That's what I love about the military, is we just give each other so much crap. I mean, we will dog each other into the ground, but at the end of the day, I will fight anyone for Matt. And Cameron, you friggin' Marines, you weirdos. So Donnie's reiterating the rules. Down with MGP. The rule is it bourbon, a rye, or burr rye? None are finished. I thought you said they were finished. What is the proof? Lastly, pick your favorite. Most of all, enjoy. Holy crap. Donnie, I thought you said they were finished. Hmm. 95 proof on D. Bourbon. One 10-ish proof, C, bourbon. Hold on, I'm gonna go through them. Let's just finish the five out. So we're on E. Cool running. What's up, brother? Old Fitz is for one. Cool running. I didn't even know you were in the UK. Secondly, holy crap. Say no. Live in bad one. I'm having 10-year whistle pig store pick, said to be 15-year MGP juice, 100% proof. From New Jersey. I've had some of those whistle pig picks that are absolutely friggin' I've never owned one, but at a bar I've had them, and they're freaking good. What are you calling a Marine with an IQ of 160? A fairy? A unicorn? Pegasus? I'm just naming things that don't exist! I'm sorry. Carlo Mack, another person that I've never recognized from my chat. What is up? It isn't necessary to insult Marines. They know. What branch are you in, Carlo? Because I'm about to make fun of you. We're on to E. And Ed Cummings is another one of my army. Oh, aren't Carlo is another army. Bring it. Army? No, Carlo. We love you. You're a good dude. In fact, you were beautiful. You were perfect. I love you. Carlo, welcome to the stream. We have bourbon for you. We have anything you want. Welcome. You were so great. In fact, you were looking great tonight, Carlo. Huh. This one's more rye-y. More of a scotch guy, but I dabble in bourbon. Still love me? Yes, Carlo, I don't care what you drink. As long as you're here, it's fine. Carlo, my channel's more... Yes, I drink literally all bourbon, and people send me rye because I don't drink rye. I don't care what you drink. Just come hang out, man. That's how we do. Britt Bailey, what is up, brother? I'm a liquor buyer, but I enjoy the bourbon community. Kevin Campbell! Kevin! What are you doing? For the car fund! Support my car! Help me drive back to work, Kevin. Man, this is... Shoot, I don't know, man. Burr Rye? The fact that Burr Rye exists freaking throws me off. Because there are high rye bourbons and there are high... low rye ryes that are in the bourbon world that I feel like Burr Rye also is in that same world. So it really throws a wrench in things. But no, that's rye. And if it's not rye, it's a Burr Rye that is high rye. That is mostly rye. Getting a lot of rye on that. Don't overthink it. Donnie, that's rye. High rye. A lot of rye. Mostly rye. It tastes like rye. That's what we're getting at. Andrew Buchanan, at least they don't send you peated scotch. If you send me peated scotch, I will drink it on stream, and I will be pissed. DC already sent me. DC the legend. Love DC. Daniel Carter is one of the greatest human beings of all time, but he sent me Ardbeg, and I drank it, and I was mad. A lot of Burr Rye's taste Finnish to me. Bam! D is a Burr Rye. D is Burr Rye, because that tasted Finnish. Will Henderson, you legend. Speaking of Will Henderson, beautiful man. Will Henderson, much better beard than me. Will Henderson sent me a flight to. So we will be doing that sometime soon, maybe next week. I don't know. You guys have overloaded me. I'm kind of backed up. But Will Henderson is a legend. We will get to it. I'm excited. I am excited. Because Will is a freaking mastermind. Let's see, who else? I saw Dustin say something important. What if I sent you amazingly lightly peated scotch? Dustin, Here's the thing. Peat isn't what I'll be honest. There's something in regular scotch. And Dustin, me and you, we've talked about this at lengths. I remember staying up well into the early hours of the night talking about this. It's not, there's something about regular scotch that really I just don't jive with. And I thought it was the barley. But me and you narrowed it down to maybe finished in bourbon barrels that I didn't like. There's something about them I'm not liking. Now, I have tried peat, and the super heavy peat nearly kills me, but the peat isn't what turns me away. I've tried peated bourbon. I've liked it. Even Lafroig 10 and the Ardbeg I've tried, even though I wasn't like, man, this is delicious. Those are the ones that I'm honestly like, I would much rather try them, to be honest. So it's not that I like them. It's just if you said, hey, here's a scotch and here's a peated scotch, which one do you want to grab? I would probably still grab the peated scotch. There's that. Stanley's going to get me those hours. Stanley, you're going to get me those hours on your own. Z-Man, cheers. Z-Man, let me know you get your package safely. Why is your favorite regional Arkansas whiskey, bourbon, rye that is tough to get in other parts of the country? Or use Whiskey Wiggle says, I think he said why, but he's saying what. Honestly, we get Weller Special Reserve here and all that crap, Elijah Craig Barrel Proof. But when you say regional Arkansas whiskey, bourbon, blah, 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 my favorite, honestly, is a bourbon that comes from Arkansas, and it would be from Rocktown, the Rocktown 4-grain single barrel barrel proof. That's my favorite regional Arkansas. All of those. It's a whiskey, bourbon, rye, wheat. And I don't think you can really get it anywhere else. But I really like it. Let's see. Let me scroll down. Let me catch back up. Will Wilson Hendo 2024. I'll make a shirt. Gosh darn it. We need to immortalize Will Henderson because he's a legend. Let me catch back up. Let me scroll down to the bottom. If I miss you, I'm sorry. Mike Ski, what's up, Trev? What's up, brother? Hot buttery rolls is in here. God dang it. Hot buttery rolls. Chris, hot buttery rolls. If you are watching me and you don't know who hot buttery rolls is, you're failing. And you owe me 50 push-ups. And you need to go to the link that's about to be dropped in the chat that says Hot Buttery Rolls channel dots link, and you need to click the link and you need to subscribe to Chris Hot Buttery Rolls. I friggin' love Chris. 115 people in here. Hit that like button. Let's get into the finishing of this MGP battle. I'm just here because I crush on Trev. Chris. Here's the thing, guys. I've met Chris in person, Hot Buttery Rolls. Amazing, amazing person. Seriously, like the best dude ever. If you want to be friends with anyone, you don't want to be friends with me. You want to be friends with Chris. So check him out. He's amazing. He's a great dude. He knows a lot more than me, and he tastes a lot more. He's better than me. If Trev would mod me, I'd have that link already. Cheech, you're in the running. I need another mod. There's a couple people in the running. I'm just seeing who's worthy. But Cheech, you're up there. Trust me, Cheech. I'm the mod. I'm the wrench. I know these things. I notice you. So we have 10 minutes left, and I have to get my answers to this. I have to give my answers. DH Silv, get on Discord more. We need you. DH Silv, I'm a lurker over on Discord. I'll do it. We'll chat. We need a chat. We need to get another Discord chat going, Dustin. Especially once I start, someone sends me some scotch. Because I'm going to need some of your answers. The only thing better than Trev is Devil Trev. Wait, I think Mike asked me something earlier that I wanted to read. Rare Breed or Russell's Single Barrel? Me, personally, that's tough because they're both really good. I would, honestly, first answer is both. If you can afford both, just get both. If you had to pick one and you wanted my opinion for whatever reason, I would honestly do Russell's Single Barrel, especially if it's a store pick, because I've had incredible store picks. But for a barrel proof bourbon that's like 46 to however many dollars, I don't know, I get it for 46, 47 bucks here. Rare Breed is really good too. So both is my answer. If you had to pick one and for whatever reason your palate aligns with mine, Russell's. J-Pitt, what's up, J-Pitt? Sorry I'm late. Freaking drink. Man, Will Henderson dropped that freaking hint of... That one's almost tasting finished too. MGP has such a wide umbrella. It's just hard. It's difficult. It's really hard. Oh God, DC, and I ain't getting involved. They're already banning people. But Will Henderson dropped that hint of finished MGP reminds you of like a burr rye, which I would never guess A as burr rye, but it does. It has this extra fruitiness on it. And that's the best way I can explain it, is this fruitiness. But, man, I don't know. I'm not an MGP pro. I've barely had any MGP pro. Go Saints! Friday at Fred's with Doug. Go Saints, baby! B's got to be bourbon. So maybe A is burr rye, just for the heck of it, but I don't know. What kind of fruit? Start there. It's weird, man. Like, I can't really pinpoint the fruit. When I say fruitiness, it's like... That's burr rye. That's got to be burr rye. I can't explain it. I'm the worst explainer of what I'm tasting. But there's like a sweetness at the very, very end of it that says like... And I'm very limited in wine, but it reminds me of that. So that's what I'm saying. B is bourbon. C's got a lot of caramel on it. Bourbon, rye, burr rye, proof. Then pick your favorite. Don't overthink it. Proof is hard, man. Like, all of these kind of seem... So, C... I don't know, man. C is like... It's lighter than the other one, so I'm thinking maybe 90. Just do what Dan does. Make up notes. Yeah, this one tastes like, whatever. That one, C is the light. I'm going to say C is 90 proof. Dude, burr eyes just really throw me off. Santa loves bourbon. Where the heck did you come from? Proof is sub 100, 100, 110, 115, 120, 125. B is higher proof. B, maybe in the 110 range. A might be 100. D. D's probably another burr rye. Just judging off of... This is all on Will Henderson, gosh darn it. Burr rye. Good work, kid. Keep drinking till you get that pump. The whiskey pump. In the words of Arnold. That one's also got that fruitiness on it. So, burr rye? Shoot, heck if I know. And then, E. Let's see what I'm going to say about E. Because then we're going to go over to ADHD Whiskey. Brandon Stipp is in here. Are you drinking Mountain Dew? And two, yes, new camera, baby. It looks good, doesn't it, Brandon? I keep calling you Brandon, dude. Stip. just poured Code Red, baby. Dude, the quality is wow. I'm legit impressed. Santa, so this is a Lumix G7. J is rye. So, 3 minutes left. I was calling... Shoot, I already forgot. That's what happens when you get slammered. I just long poured A because I needed to know. I guess... And I'm totally... Will Henderson, I'm basing this off of all of your notes. All of your notes. If it smells fruity and tastes fruity, I'm calling it burr rye. Burr rye. I'm calling it A is burr rye. 100 proof. B, bourbon. 110. Shoot, that could even, whatever. Bourbon, 110. E. Bourbon, lower, 95. F, burr rye. Again, maybe lower. 90. E, rye. E is rye. And, shoot, 100 proof. That's what I'm guessing. Donnie also just texted me. Oh, he sent me the answers. So B, so A was Nevada Distilling Smoke Wagon Small Batch, 100 proof. Straight bourbon. I'm already wrong. I guess that burr rye. Sorry, guys. And let's finish this and so we can go to ADHD Whiskey. I'm always late over there. He's doing an awesome giveaway. So let's go through these answers. Totally wrong. That's really good. Smoke Wagon Uncut Unfiltered 113. So I did guess the proof on that. I have that one. I think I guess 110 on C, on B. So I'm in the neighborhood. C, I guessed bourbon. Redwood Empire Pipe Dream Bourbon 90 proof. I think that's what I guessed. I think I guessed 90 proof. Or 95 in the neighborhood. A, B, C. D was Redwood Empire Lost Monarch 90 proof. What? What? Really good. That one's actually, that Lost Monarch is delicious. So if you guys can get it. Dang, Donnie sent me all Redwood Empire, then Jay. Okay, thank God I guessed rye. On E, I guessed rye, and it was. Redwood Empire Emerald Giant Rye, 90 proof. 95.5 rye. So this is a high rye rye. A high rye rye. That's actually pretty good. Especially for someone who's new into getting a rye. And you want to try high rye. Get that. So. With that being said. We finished it. Holy crap. I'm a little bit slammered. Thank you for sticking around for two flights. Mark Bond, Donnie the Linux Cat, Miss Linux Cat. I know you're lurking in the background. I know you're there. Thank you for these flights. Thank you for the entertainment. Carlo Mack, great stream, man. First time seeing your channel, but I'm hitting the red button. Nice job. Carlo, welcome aboard, brother. I don't know how you found me, but thank you. ET Phone Home, thanks. Linux Cat, you did awesome. Yeah, Donnie, this makes up for the last one for sure. Nick P, the Lost Monarchs are delicious. They are very delicious. Let's see. Everyone saying cheers, 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 cheers. Mark Bond, again, thank you, man. Tim Evans, thank you. William and friggin' Michelle, thank you guys for being here. Will Henderson, sorry, man. Will, you led me astray, but whatever, dude. I'm coming for you, DC. Okay. You're unbanned. Okay. If you don't know ADHD Whiskey, and you're here, then you need to go click the link that someone's about to drop to ADHD Whiskey's stream. He's going live. He's having an epic giveaway tonight. Normally, I do some cool giveaways. I took the night off. I'm feeling a little ill. You know, the deer hurt me. But next week we'll do some giveaways. Next week we'll do some giveaways. If you're still here, and you haven't left me already, I'll give away some samples of this guy. If you're still here. Because this dude, I got at retail. I've got this dude at retail. I will give away samples because you guys need to try it. And if you haven't tried this and you want to try it, that's what's in the giveaway. So that's what's going to happen. If you want some samples of some E.H. Taylor barrel proof, we'll give that away too. We'll give away some hitter samples next time. This time we took it easy. So, that being said, now that is interesting. How do I send you a sample of perfect scotch for bourbon drinkers? Carlo, bourbonwrench@gmail.com. So, thank you guys. UT Massey, where the heck have you been? Yeah, we'll give giveaways next time. Tune in next time. Who the heck are you? Come back, bro. Come back. So, thank you guys. Go check out ADHD Whiskey. He's going live. He's live right now. He's doing a giveaway on his stream. I know that for a fact. because he messaged me. He told me we need to keep track of Super Chat. So that means giveaway. So go check out. There's the link. ADHD Whiskey Stream. Thank you guys for tuning in. If you're still here, thank you. Thank you for checking on me after this whole freaking deer accident. Thank you for watching me drink 18 samples. Love you guys. I'm a little bit slammered. I'm not done yet. I'm ready to keep going. Stip, when's late night Warzone starting? Because I'm ready to get on Warzone. Stip doesn't even know about this. Stip on Call of Duty, I'll tell you. Will, I love you anyway too, you douche. All right, see you guys. Go check out ADHD Whiskey. I'll catch the, you'll see me in there. I'll be keeping track of some Super Chats. Because we got a giveaway going over there. So, thank you guys. Love you. See you next time. I might be trying to do a live stream before Friday. If not, I will see you Friday. So, love you guys. Thank you. See you next time. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Love you guys. See you.